Hey everyone, thanks for stopping by the Movie Hangout, and let's talk about the Star Wars 9 that got shelved. Yes, there was a totally different story that was already written that they were going to do, but lo and behold, we got what we got. But before I jump into what could have been, what amazing film that the fans deserved, before I jump into that, if you click the subscribe button, hit the notification bell, comment, and like this video, because I want to hear what your opinion is on this. Do you think that this concept, this story, it would have been superior to The Rise of Skywalker? I think I know what your answer is going to be, but I still want to hear what your opinion is, or if you got like a different idea that, you know, would have worked better. I want to hear it because I think there's more creativity out in the YouTube sphere than in Hollywood right now. Just my opinion. All right, so I'm here over here. Now, this is kind of an oldie but a goodie article. I just wanted to kind of touch base on it because it still rubs me the wrong way how the new trilogy ended up with Star Wars. You know, it's like, what could have been? I just feel like we were depraved of what we deserved by just being loyal to that property, to that story, you know, buying the toys, buying the memorabilia, and then we're just like a big slap in the face. So I'm over at Esquire. The full original Star Wars 9 script has been supposedly leaked, and it gives fans the ending they deserve. I don't think anything has ever really leaked. Colin Trevorrow's Duel of Fates is dark, it's metal, and unlike Rise of Skywalker, it makes some really bold choices. I think Rise of Skywalker did make some bold choices, but they were just totally wrong. 16 pages into the recently leaked script for Duel of Fates, which may or may not be completely fake, an alien is executed by a lightsaber guillotine. Interesting. 5 pages after that, Kylo Ren's face is violently mutilated by a surge of red lightning. His skin is later scalded with a mask made for burning hot Mandalorian iron. In the end, Rey's eyes are carterized, and Hux, now a chancellor of the First Order, commits seppuku. Seppuku? I don't think I pronounced that right, but with a decorative lightsaber. Star Wars has had heavy metal vibes before, but this script, whether it's real or not, feels like it was found bubbling up from the depths of HE double hockey sticks. This is like death metal, man, and I'm into it. First, there was a script breakdown last month, then the leaked concept art, which was verified by Trevorrow himself. After that, screenshots of an actual script began appearing on Twitter and Reddit. The elusive PDF allegedly was Colin Trevorrow's original plan for episode 9 that was abruptly canceled when Disney fired him in 2017, or at least some semblance of what he had in mind. It says that there's a PDF that was finally shared in full. We have no way of knowing if the script is legit. I kind of think it might be. And even if it really is an early draft of the project, it's worth keeping in mind that at the time, Carrie Fisher was still alive. Disney really blew that. I mean, gosh, you had Han Solo was alive. I mean, you had everybody was alive. And it's just put them all together in one scene. And I don't know. I think I might do a breakdown of what I think the story should have been. It'll be pretty extensive, but I think it's way better than what they came up with. But I'll do that in a later video. So things were inevitably set to change in a pretty big way anyway. But if you've been keeping up with all the leaks, it is kind of hard to believe that this draft is anything but the real deal. The screenwriting is world class. No offense to fan fiction writers, but this is not fan fiction. If it's fake, then whomever wrote this has a future in show business. In the script, the entire galaxy, not just the heroes of the Resistance, has been utterly crushed by the fascist regime of the First Order. Not just dominated, crushed. Chancellor Hux rules over the world of Star Wars with an iron fist, and unlike relatively inconsequential Final Order we saw in Rise of Skywalker, The new empire in Duel of Fates is a real force of devastation. It's a vision for the final act of the Skywalker saga that feels downright apocalyptic. The same apocalyptic sort of imagery we saw in the leaked batch of concept art from a few weeks ago. Much of Duel of Fates takes place on Coruscant, where the First Order has established their stronghold. Finn, Poe, Rey, and Rose Tico, yes, Rose Tico, who has a deservedly large role in this version of Episode 9, are operating undercover, attempting to detonate an orbital ring that would bring sure disaster to Hux's gigantic military operation. Rey begins the film disguised as a Tusken Raider while she whips out her double-sided blue lightsaber to lead the resistance as the last Jedi, a hero, an inspiration to all. Kylo Ren, absent from the opening of the film, is on a mission of his own. Just as we saw in the concept art, he's lurking around Darth Vader's castle on Mustafar in search of an ancient well of power from a Sith temple known as Mortis. And again, just as the leaked imagery showed us, he's being haunted by the ghost of Luke Skywalker. The sequences would have given Mark Hamill a chance to actually show off his range, as he did in Last Jedi. I kind of disagree with that. I don't think he really showed much of range in that movie. It was kind of one note, but I digress. The two stories converge when Rey discovers Ren's quest for an unbeatable ancient Sith power, which, by the way, he almost fully attains. Rey goes to stop Ren, who, after being trained by the Sith monster who instructed Emperor Palpatine's master, has finally gone full Sith with a Darth Vader mask of his own. While Rey tracks down Ren and cuts through the satisfyingly vicious Knights of Ren, along the way, Leia and the Resistance concoct a plan to send out a beacon across the galaxy and search for someone, anyone, to come help kill the First Order. The beacon is analog, so it's undetectable by the new Empire's advanced fleet. And when it comes to the bowels of the Jedi Temple on Coruscant, clearly this is a very different story than Rise of Skywalker. Better or not, what's evident on the pages of this unverified text, the writers, if they really are, were Trevorrow and Connolly, were prepared to make some choices, not small choices like unplugging C-3PO. Let's see. It says, Finn, for instance, inspires First Order stormtroopers to find something worth fighting for with his help, and by harnessing his traumatic past, he's able to turn the tide and preach the good word of the Resistance to his former brothers. It's a character beat that feels not only satisfying, but necessary. You know, that sounds pretty darn good, right? I mean, I always thought the Finn character was just like a total waste because he's supposedly supposed to be like a space marine, right? I mean, he's been groomed his whole life. He's been trained to be an awesome fighter, but he wasn't really that great at fighting. I mean, they should have shown him, you know, getting different weapons and taking them apart and putting them back together, or like constructing a different weapon, you know, just really showing his military background and then teaching other people that, you know, maybe teaching Rey some military tactics, because how would she know? She would have no idea. But they just kind of had him just kind of a tag along character that would fumble around. Really just a blown opportunity. It says, Poe gets to have his Han Solo moment. The character has always been Solo adjacent, but in Duel of Fates, Trevorrow and Connolly have him and Rey in a sort of Empire Strikes Back. Will they or won't they thing? The script sends the odd couple off together and the characters get to fulfill their attraction for each other. And then it says, even Chewie gets his due. Yeah, I mean, they just kind of wasted Chewie, right? I mean, the only thing I remember about Chewie is that he freaks out when Han Solo passes away, obviously. I mean, you're expecting that. And then he ends up roasting like one of those little, like, they almost look like a puffin type of alien creature. And he's like cooking one. That's all I remember about his character. Like, they totally blew that. Towards the big finale, a starship battle that takes place mostly in the skies of Coruscant, Chewbacca is left without a ship of his own, so he decides to hop into an X-Wing. That'd be kind of cool. And he kicks some butt, as he should. The big dude is almost a century old at this point. He's been flying since before all these pilots were born. Yeah, I mean, another missed opportunity to really show, like, somebody's skill set, you know? So anyway, it's like what could have been, you know? It's like, what? There were an infinite number of stories you could tell with the new trilogy, right? I mean, you had, you know, the basic framework that was left behind by George Lucas, but then you could have gone in an infinite number of directions, but they chose what they chose. And then they attacked fans for being upset about it. And it's just crazy. It would have been better if they waited like another 5 years to come out with these films and really nail down like an arc, a 3-film arc for every character, you know, and then really give them a good send off. But unfortunately, that's not what we got, you know. Rather than filet mignon, we got ballpark franks, you know. Unfortunately, it's kind of how it is right now. But anyway, let me know what you think. Do you think that this sounds like a better story than what we got in The Rise of Skywalker? Or, you know, are there other ideas that you have that you think would be even better, that would have raised the stakes, that would have been more entertaining? Comment below, let me know, because I want to read them. And I might add what I think as well. And anyways, if you want to get future rants, reviews, original content, click subscribe. Later.